Hello guys, and welcome, we are here back again on the MC Venom server for another episode of Benoko Builds. And as you can see, I did my share of work on the tower and looks pretty good, I think, looks pretty good so far. We basically got some detail work on the sides here done, but as I'm standing here now, I see already a few things that are missing and I will add them. And on the inside I didn't do as much as I wanted to do. Alright, and I forgot to do one thing earlier, and that was that going like so, and just having those in here. And on the inside I added floors, a ladder up in the second floor, a floor here, here is the glass still missing, and a ladder up here. Up here I want to make it a little bit outgoing, like a little platform where the imaginary guards can walk around and scan the surroundings for enemies. And we need a little ladder up here to the top platform, where I can just pull up real quick to show to you, where we have those fences. And yeah, we want a ladder up here as well. But I didn't do much work building wise other than that. Well, I did some more layout stuff, and for one I added a house here, and I'm experimenting a bit with the roof detail up there, cause I wanted it to look not the same as here. Well, it looks pretty good here, but oh yeah, I'm not sure if it looks good. Well, I want to change those parts up there up a bit, because yeah, they are quite a bit bland and we don't want that. So okay, then we have another house in here, didn't do much with it so far, but I will add on another one here and a small one here and later on another one here where the sheeps are living now. Oops. Because we want to move the sheeps later on over to here, where we basically said we want to have our little farm building, or yeah, farm building is I think the right word to use. And you might have seen it already, we got a beacon. And don't yell at me, you will get to see the withered up fight we had as well, but I'm fought the wither together with Schnurrus again, who is not on anymore. And he has some footage waiting still, so we agreed to publish our wither killing episodes together, so we have to wait a bit. Well, you have to wait a bit to get them up, but I hope you will forgive me for that and just be patient. Okay, and another thing, well, I will show you the beacon in a second, but I want to get some light on here, and I want to sleep to get rid of the rain, because nobody likes rain. Right, guys? Yep, that's right. And doop, jump into the bed. Ah, good morning. A nice sunny day again. I wish it would work like that in real life. Rains and you just go to sleep and wake up instantly and the rain's gone. Ha, that would be so nice. Ah, well. Okay. Back to business. I started with the marketplace we planned for here, but I think that is too small. Marketplaces have to be bigger. So, we have 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 and 10 in this direction in this direction. Meaning we have a circle with a diameter of 21. And we will have later on 4 circles with a diameter of 21. Going, well, another one will be here, like this. Then we will have another one going from here over there. We might have to cut a bit into this mountain. God! Got him. We will probably have to cut a bit into this mountain, but no problem there. And yeah, this will be the marketplace. I will fill it in with little stands and yeah, stuff where you can, well, where you could buy stuff if this would be possible in Minecraft, but it isn't. Well, yeah, but that's the idea anyways. And we will have an inn at the marketplace somewhere, probably around over there-ish, or yeah, we will see. We will see once it's finished. But we will have an inn, and we will have more houses going along this side here, and behind here, where the where our XP grinder is. Yeah, and speaking about XP grinder, that's right the next topic I want to talk about. And, well, as you guys probably know, Schnurris and I aren't the only ones playing on the server. There are more guys, but those are from America and I'm from Germany. So you will probably not see them very often in my videos, sadly, because when they are playing, I can't be up anymore because I have to go to university and be a good student. So I have to go to bed early. But they killed the Ender Dragon without saying anything to Schnurris and me. So, yeah. You guys will probably miss out the fun, and I'm really sorry about that. But we will build an Ender, meaning a big and efficient Enderman XP farm in there as our next project. But we have to stock up on iron first, because as you can see, yep, I'm almost out. And we will need at least 11 stacks of iron, I think it is. Yeah, 9 stacks of pistons and 2 stacks of tripwire hooks. Yeah, 11 stacks. So yeah, that's going to be fun to farm. I was caving for a few hours yesterday as well, because I wanted to get the beacon set up and ready. And yeah, so I have been caving quite a bit in the last days. But it is still fun. Yeah, and I died during the wither fight, hence my awesome armor I'm wearing at the moment. Oh, speaking of that, we could go to the zombie grind and check out if we have some nice golden bling bling armor I could use temporarily. Okay, let's see. Oh, jump down here. Da, da, da. What do we have here? Oh, projectile protection 3, unbreaking 2. Hell yeah, fully repaired. Oh, ah, yeah. Yeah, it's fully repaired. I take that. We need pants. Sub protection 2 pants. Work with me. Feather falling 4 golden boots. Well, let's see. Maybe we have. Holy crap. I take those. Definitely. Oh, maybe we can repair them. I think leather boots aren't that expensive to repair, if I remember correctly. Let's see. And if not, we'll just take them. I mean, eh, who cares? Those are only leather boots, so. Not like they are diamond or something. Okay, get my leather going. Come on. Now we will then try a few things. Going with another pair of boots and with. Okay, get that in. Whoa, 25 levels. A cheaper? No, that's not cheaper. Ah well, has to work. At least we got feather falling. And feather falling is always helpful. Oh, some more stuff in here. Anything interesting? No. Oh, and I think we will dye them green. I like green. We will dye them green. Yep. Ah, totally going to have them. So, bam, that in here. Okay, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Where's our dye? Our dye is in here. And as it happens, we have some lime green dye over. Woo! Green boots! Yay! Fancy! Okay, now that we are armored up, I reckon we are just going to go down to the beacon real quick, and after that we are going to do some probably detail work on we did detail work on the houses already. I will think of something we can do, or maybe just call it quits depending on how long we went. And go down here is my strip mine, where I did all my strip mining and diamond grinding so far. Yeah, I was caving one day and then just dug up here. Well, I found the spawner while caving and dug up from it. Here was the spawner. It got blown up by a creeper, unfortunately, Ah, but oh well. What you gonna do? And I just went down here. Level 12. Here's my strip mine. I really like the strip mining on level 12 because it's pretty likely that you will find diamonds on that level pretty fast, so yeah. And if we go over to here, through here, da, 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 da. Here is our beacon. Complete with iron blocks, and the top is set to gold, and we have haste 2 from it, as you can see here. So why do we have haste 2? If you remember correctly, we have an efficiency 5 pickaxe, our good old trusty work drop, and then you can just do... Whoops, didn't mean to mine that redstone. Oh, double crit. Yep, then you can just do that. You basically just blast through the stone. And yeah, get really quick some resource going. But you have to be careful that your pickaxe doesn't break, obviously. And you have to be careful of lava, as we can see right here. Because lava is like everywhere down here. But since you are basically able to shred through that stone, you are able to mine pretty quick and efficiently. Do you need that? Ah, I don't know. But you get much shit pretty fast, to put it short. And that's why I'm running around with fire resistance potions as well. I don't want to die in lava. Yeah, but if you have a bucket, it's not really a problem. If you're fast. Yeah, and I set this thing up down here and already did a small amount of digging to make a little room for the beacon, as you can see. And yeah, I set up a little base camp, but I don't really want to do stuff until I got my ender chest down here. But freaking endermen are not nice to me and are not giving me any ender balls, or ender pearls, they are called. Oh, look there, we have some redstone, some gold, and haha, see? Instantly found some diamonds. That's how we roll, guys, that's how we roll. Oh well, I don't have my selector with me, great. Yeah, I will just keep them in there and come back later, get them. It's only one, too bad, it's only one block. Well, I guess we shouldn't complain. Diamonds are still diamonds. And with Silk Touch they can be up to 4. So it's not too bad. Yeah. And this mining is actually pretty fun because you can just blast through stuff. And I gotta be a bit careful not to mine the valuable blocks if you want to fortune them. If you don't want to fortune them, it doesn't really matter. But yeah, if you want, you have to be a bit careful. And this method, I got this method from Etho, who you guys might know as well. He is pretty popular amongst the kids. And he has an awesome Let's Play series, and he is a member of the Mindcrack server as well. And he posted a video a few days ago showing off the method, and I will, of course, link you guys in the description of the video so you can check it out for yourself and go and check Etho out. Yeah, and we will basically now go ahead and mine a 50 by 50 area out. Well, I will go ahead off camera, you won't be with me. But I will mine out that 50 by 50 area. And then I will just move the beacon, and yeah. All is fine and dandy, because a max size beacon has a range of 50 blocks in every direction. Oh, so I lied, it's a 100 by 100 area that we are going to mine out. But, well, anyways, a pretty, pretty damn big area. And we will probably get a metric shit ton of resources. Ooh, I'm sorry. From it, and yeah. Looking forward to that. And we will need those resources as well. Because once we have the Ender up and running, I will probably do a ton of enchanting to get some pretty good things going. Oh yeah, and I did some book enchanting as well earlier, but I sadly got nothing good from it. I got like efficiency 3, well, it's decent. I got Bane of Useless Opods, or Bane of Arthropods 4, which is, well, goddamn useless. And I got Sharpen 3, which is pretty decent, I think. If I can get another Sharpen 3, I can upgrade my sword to Sharpness 5, which would be awesome. And then I probably will just try to get Unbreaking on it, or... Yeah, Unbreaking, and well, I guess looting is already a bit excessive on it, because then it will be pretty expensive to repair. But well, the goal is to get Unbreaking on it as well. Sharpness 5 Unbreaking is pretty damn decent, I would say. Well, but looking at my time and at the clock, this is it already. I gave you guys a little update. I hope you enjoyed. And I will see you guys next time when I show you how I finished the tower off and when I hopefully got the marketplace and a few more houses done. Until then, I hope you will have a nice day, a nice rest of the Sunday, and I wish you guys a good week. Bye bye. See ya.